Kingwood. He has one today and he had one yesterday for two goals. Near side boards, 14:02 remaining. We get a helmet knocked off. Play continues. And getting his helmet is Dahl. He just says, I'm done with it. And he slides it out and goes off the ice. Play continues. Now here's a shot. One today and he had one yesterday for two goals. Near side boards, 14:02 remaining. We get a helmet knocked off. Play continues. And getting his helmet is Dahl. He just says, I'm done with it. And he slides it out and goes off the ice. Play continues. Now here's a shot. right.
Thank you.
has two goals. Dahl sends it down in low. Two goals. Dahl sends it down in low. Two goals. Dahl sends it down in low. Sends it down in low.
SportsRadio.com in association with KBFL proudly presents.
Pass from Kovacic went a little bit too hard, and it was off of Zane O'Brien's stick. Now Turin spins around. O'Brien has it. He shoots. He scores!
Missouri State University ice hockey.
Zane O'Brien ties the hockey game up. Dawes again, and he shoots. Save Stevens. Rebound. It's moved into the corner. Left side, Wilk. Great diving play by Bell, and he's able to clear it out the center ice. Huge, huge scenario right there for Missouri State. Here come the Ice Bears breaking in. Kovacic all alone. He shoots. He scores!
With the call, here's Steve Kasson.
And live from MediaCom Ice Park in the stand, Melton Ice Arena. It is Pink the Rink night without the pink rink here as Missouri State for Breast Cancer Awareness Month help out the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks, and they will be wearing their pink jerseys tonight. The referees will be adorned with pink referee-type jerseys, too. All of them will be up for auction tomorrow right here at MediaCom Ice Park. It is another sold-out or close-to-sold-out arena as the Ice Bears come back from a 1-2 road trip. Missouri State with a 2-0 win over the University of Arizona, but then they lose a couple of games to Arizona State by 5-4 and 5-3. This is a Missouri State team that is 7-5-1-1. They have a shootout loss and an overtime loss, and those came against Oklahoma. They get their first win against Oklahoma a couple of weekends ago. Now, with the human rankings, Missouri State in ACHA Division I play, they were ranked 18, but now with the computer ranking, they are 22nd. So Missouri State, 22nd in the ACHA Division I. They are number 3 in the Western Collegiate Hockey League. Well, they're actually tied for first, but they have 9 points, as do 5 other teams have 9 points, but by virtue of the potential of games played versus potential points that they could have achieved, they are in third place right now. Missouri State at home, they are 3-2 with an overtime loss at home, and they're going to be playing a Division II squad, the St. Louis Billikens. They are 8-2 this season, 6-2 in the Mid-America Collegiate Hockey Association. They are first in MACA. And as I mentioned, 8-2 this season, and right now they are coming off of a couple of wins against the Lindenwood University Lions Division II. They also had a couple of wins against Iowa State. So very tough, very good St. Louis Billiken team in Division II, and we look forward to what should be a pretty good game. And coming up at the first period intermission, we'll talk with Sean Fitzpatrick, the head coach of the St. Louis University Billikens. In nets, speaking of that, for St. Louis, it'll be Alex Dirks, the junior out of Madison, Wisconsin. Dirks is 7-2 with a 2.67 goals against average and a 928 save percentage. For Missouri State, in nets, Joey McConnell, the senior, he's 2-1 with a 3.57 goals against average and an 876 save percentage. He's allowed 11 goals this season. The referees for tonight's contest, they will include Jason Carrera, and actually I should have said the officials. Jason Carrera is the referee. Craig Smith and Mark Marzola are the linesmen. Because it's Division II, there will only be 3 officials on the ice. Division I does have 2 referees and 2 linesmen. St. Louis making their way onto the ice, and in just a moment we will have the Missouri State Ice Bears being introduced as the flag comes out here at MediaCom. And look at those jerseys. Those are just some incredible jerseys that I think are the best they've ever produced here. And they will be up for auction on Saturday night. Head coach Jeremy Law, his first season with Missouri State, and he has brought this team together. They, with the exception of 2 losses, all their losses have been 1-goal games. This is just two, and including the loss just last weekend, the one of two losses that was a 5-3 defeat to Arizona State. They've only lost one other time. Let's take a look at the starting lineups for the St. Louis University Billikens. Here's Kevin Thurow.
Starting at a forward from Castle Pines, Colorado, number 12, Dylan Kelly. Starting at a forward from St. Louis, Missouri, number 4, Gunnar O'Brien. Starting at a forward from West Bend, number 7, Isaac Ryder. Starting on defense, number 16, Blake Friend. Starting on defense from Overland Park, Kansas, number 2, Colin Beischel. And in the net tonight for the St. Louis University Billikens from Madison, Wisconsin, number 30, Alec Dirks. The St. Louis University Billikens are coached by head coach Sean Fitzpatrick. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time. Everyone on your feet and make some noise. Let's meet your starters for your Missouri State Ice Bears. Starting at a forward from Fenton, Missouri, number 18, Brendan McClure. Starting at a forward from St. Louis, Missouri, number 10, Alex Turin. Starting at a forward and also from St. Louis, Missouri, number 20, Andrew Kovacic. Starting at defense for the Bears from Sarunda, number 58, Patrick Johansson. Starting on defense from St. Peter's, Missouri, number 6, Brian Fuller. And starting in goal tonight for the Missouri State Ice Bears from Fairview Heights, Illinois, number 29, Joseph McConnell. Joining the Ice Bears on the ice tonight is 12-year-old Noah Boyd, a student at St. Elizabeth Ann Seton and a part of the MediaCom Ice Park Junior Bears Youth Hockey Club. Let's hear it for Noah Boyd. The Bears are coached by head coach Jeremy Law and assistant coach Ryan Armstrong. Ladies and gentlemen, joining us on the ice tonight for the ceremonial puck drop is Dr. Brian Biggers with Creighton Olive Dunn Surgical Group, is the area's only board-certified breast oncologist. Dr. Biggers is a Marshfield native and enjoys serving his community through being on the board of the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks. Let's give a nice welcome to Dr. Brian Biggers. And also joining us on the ice tonight, joining Dr. Biggers, is Gail Calhoun, a breast cancer survivor herself. Gail is the mother of Valinda Bradley and the grandmother of Corbin Bradley, who are both on the staff of the Missouri State Ice Bears and members of the Missouri State Ice Bears Booster Club. Let's welcome breast cancer survivor Gail Calhoun. Fans, let's hear it for Dr. Brian Biggers and Gail Calhoun, tonight's ceremonial puck droppers.
And of course, these jerseys that you see almost everyone wearing on the ice will be auctioned off tomorrow after the second period. There is a buy it now price of $250.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing. And gentlemen, please remove your caps for this evening's presentation of the national anthem by Terry Powell.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled
once again, our national anthem from Mediacom Ice Park, the Stan Melton Ice Arena. First game of two between Missouri State, ACHA Division I, and St. Louis University, ACHA Division II. St. Louis was a Division I squad at one time, but it's been several years since they've moved down. So we'll see what happens here as Missouri State getting their last-minute preparations and talk to from head coach Jeremy Law. They'll be skating from the left to the right, and from the right to the left, it will be the Billikens. I'm Steve Casson along with Alex Salm. Thanks for joining us on West Sports Radio on a KBFL. For the Missouri State Ice Bears, Captain Brendan McClue, and off the draw, he wins it from Dylan Kelly, and it's sent right down to the Missouri State end. Chased quickly and banked off the boards by Brian Fuller, stays in the zone right immediately as McConnell has to make a save on the first shot of the game for St. Louis. So the Billikens mean business. First line change will go to St. Louis. Coming in to take the draw will be Niall Capron. Capron leads the team with 17 assists, 5 goals and 17 assists. Puck sent down in low. Now the Ice Bears will have control of the puck and quickly get it out to center ice, but that's as far as it goes as Capron is putting a lot of pressure. Comes back into the Slew's zone. Dirk sticks it over to the corner. Now to the far side. It'll go to Patrick Pence. He gets it out to center ice, and Missouri State breaks it up. They'll slowly get out to center ice and send it right back in. Delayed offside. It'll be Blake Friend with it. Friend's pass up to center ice, intercepted by Brown of Missouri State. That's Chris Brown. The St. Louis product has 3 assists. The sophomore listed at 6'2". Puck comes in the Missouri State zone quickly. Brennan Anderson gives it up to center ice. Nice lead pass to Barrett. He gets a drive off and a blocker saved by Dirks. Rebound in front and a save again by Dirks on the second effort shot by Barrett of Missouri State. Travis Barrett, he gets a couple of good ones, and now we get a whistle for a stoppage and play on the icing call to bring it back down into the St. Louis end. 18:51 remaining in the period. Shots are 2 apiece between these two clubs. Face off the right of Alec Dirks, the junior from Madison, Wisconsin. Dirks 7-2 this season. Puck to the far side. And Pence, can he clear it? He does, all the way down to the Missouri State zone where it'll be chased by the Ice Bears. Picked up by Sam Heiserud, gets it to the far side. Now worked by Alex Smith down in low to the near side boards. Line change for St. Louis again. They're going to change up in a hurry. Puck is cleared out to center ice, and slowly it'll get to Max Faddle. He sends it up, and the Ice Bears intercept. They were offside. It's Marshall Gievers with it. Sends it into the corner and out to center. Quickly taken away by St. Louis. Tipped into the corner now by Smith. He's going to drive all the way down. He gets hit hard. Puck comes right up the middle, but we're going to get a penalty. First penalty of the game is an interference call. And it will go against St. Louis. Getting called is James Kohlstock for interference. And the Ice Bears will go on the power play. So Kohlstock gets called. Missouri State on the power play. 25%, 18 power play goals for 72 opportunities on the penalty kill. The Billikens are 83%, or 83.6% actually. They've allowed 8 for 49 opportunities the opponents have had. Icebergs quickly regain control after the faceoff. Now they'll bring it to Alex Turin. He'll send it all the way around, get it to Andrew Kovacic, leading scorer for Missouri State. Kovacic, 12 goals, 6 assists. It'll go to Kovacic again. He drops it down in low to Brown. Cross-ice pass. Here's a drive that's partially blocked as it came off of the stick of Brennan Anderson, the captain of Missouri State. 17:44 remains in the period. Faceoff will stay in the zone as it went off of Billiken. Coming in to take the draw is Brendan McClue for Missouri State. For St. Louis, it's Isaac Ryder, and off the draw, Ryder does win it. Puck is held along the line, stays in by Anderson. Rebound is now taken away. The rebound deflection is out to center ice. Anderson brings it in, a delayed offside. Puck will be shot down by Max Faddle all the way down to the Missouri State zone. It's cleared. 1:17 remaining in the period. Here come the Ice Bears. They break a 3-on-3 into the zone. Leading it on the right side is McClue. Tries to step around one. He does. McClue with a bouncer in and a save by Dirks. He holds on. Faceoff will stay in the zone. 17:14 to go in the period. 1:04 remaining in the power play. So Brendan McClue, who was out 13 games because of eligibility. Last season he was injured. He only played a handful of games, and the ACHA said you can go ahead and play as a fifth-year senior, but you have X amount of games you need to sit out because of the eligibility. That was 13. He played on the last game of the road trip in Arizona last weekend. That, of course, a 5-3 loss for Missouri State. Here is Patrick Johansson across the line for the Ice Bears. Johansson sends it to the half board, still waiting for someone to pass to. Johansson with it, gets it to their right point to Bratton, left side now, drive in. It's big save by Dirks as he holds on. Drive in from Sam Heiserote from the left side, and Dirks through some traffic is able to grab control. 16:50 remaining in the period. 40 seconds left in the power play. Face off the right of Dirks. And off the draw, it's won by Missouri State. They have possession again. Heiserote calling for the puck, but instead coming down is Johansson. Tried to pass it up the middle through the slot. It's intercepted. And with some numbers, here's Gunnar O'Brien. Right side, he shoots. It gets deflected up, been out of play. 16:36 remaining in the period. Faceoff will come to the right of Joseph McConnell. Right as you look at it, his left. And again, if you're just joining us late, this is our normal Pink the Rink games for breast cancer awareness and the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozark, but no pink ice this time. Puck is shot in. It's deflected. It'll go to the corner. Usually it's a Division II team that gets to suffer on the pink ice, but this year, not happening. Puck across the slough line, taken away by Isaac Ryder, and now finally cleared by Gunnar O'Brien in a line change for St. Louis. 3 seconds remaining in the power play. It's over. Now we're back at full strength. Here come the Ice Bears. 2-on-1. Barrett left side drive and a save. Good job by Dirks as it was Barrett and Zane O'Brien working on that 2-on-1. Now O'Brien gets it to Barrett right through the slot. It'll go to the near side and deflected and cleared up and out all the way down off of the stick of Adam Dettenmeyer. Dettenmeyer with 13 goals and 5 assists. He's on the same line as Niall Capron. And you can do the math. 13 goals for Dettenmeyer, 17 assists for Capron. They work well together. Faceoff will come back into the St. Louis zone on the icing. First shift for Blake Sabinski. He's been out after a shoulder issue, that is. Now here's a lead pass coming to Patrick Pence. He breaks free all alone. It's poked away. Good play by Joey McConnell, and the Ice Bears come back. They have a 3-on-2, bringing it across the line. Now into the zone. Here is Austin Davis. He gets hit up high, hard behind the net. Play continues. Goes to the corner now. Referee moves out of the way. Scrum at the right, left faceoff dot, that is. It'll go to the near side to Carter Alcock out of Parker, Colorado. Sent down in low. Go to the far side, where this time it'll be chased by Chad Lounder. Lounder behind the net. He is hooked by Friend. Play continues there. Friend with all sorts of pressure. He runs Lounder down. Play continues. Now intercepted by Austin Davis of Missouri State. Davis gives it back to Lounder. Nobody in front for the Ice Bears. Lounder gets hit down. No penalty. Play is continued. And it's out to center ice. Ice Bears quickly wait for everyone to get onside. They do. Here's Heiseroth, that is, with a shot save. Rebound, and Zabinski had it hop over his stick. Come the other way. Lead pass broken up by Anderson of Missouri State. He gets it to Andrew Kovacic of the Ice Bears as Missouri State line changes. Kovacic with a shot saved by Dirks, and he says, I'm going to hold on to it. He tells Blake Friend to give it to him. He holds on with 14:26 to go in the period. And a faceoff. We'll bring it to the left side this time. Right of Dirks, left as you look at it. Face off of the right of Dirks is won by the Ice Bears once again. They have it left side, shot sails wide. 14:20 to go in the period, no score. Puck taken away, flipped out to center ice. This is not a hand pass. Johansson tried to get it to Turin. Broken up. Here come the Ice Bears momentarily with possession. Now it'll go out to Johansson. He'll set things up again. Out of the Missouri State zone. Return puck to Hansen, but he sends it all the way down too far for Brendan McClue, so we have an icing call. 13:52 remaining in the period. Icing will bring it back down into the Missouri State, into the ice. McClue will come in to take the draw, number 18, and his like number 18 will be James Kolstok of St. Louis. And off the draw, won by the Billikens, immediately a shot up high by Alex Smith, sails wide, and it caroms out the boards and all the way down. Pushed back by Kovacic, checks it into the corner, moves it to Turin. Now spun around by McClue. Helping out is Smith, and he'll dig it out. Then backhanded all the way down to the Missouri State end of the ice. Icing is waved off. Kolstok to chase. Intercepted by the Ice Bears. Brown to the near side. Here comes Missouri State. 2-on-2. McClue into the zone. Looking for help. Nothing there. Gets it to the far side. Now here is Smith. He'll have it. He shoots through some traffic. It was blocked inadvertently. Smith keeps it to the right side. McClue goes to the bench. St. Louis with Kolstok clears it out to center. Hops over the stick of Luke Horn. Now intercepted by Missouri State. 12:56 to go. Ice Bears lose the puck. Taken away by Smith. Shoved all the way down, and Smith goes for a line change. Now Bradley Turkjelian. He goes into forecheck. Ice Bears clear it out to center ice. They move it to the left side. Here's Marshall Gievers looking in front, but instead gets a shot off from an angle low along the left faceoff dot. It's covered up by Dirks. He'll hold on with 12:36 to go in the period. No score. Shots 8-2 in favor of Missouri State. These same two teams tomorrow will have it for you right here on KBFL and on Web Sports Radio. Thanks for joining us. Off the draw. Puck is one from Bratton. It'll go to the corner now. Charlie West with it. He clears it for St. Louis out to center ice. Puck intercepted by Nick Krivokucha, and he goes offside. So the faceoff with 12:22 remaining in the period will be just outside the Missouri State end of the ice. Mentioned Niall Capron, the leader, 5 goals, 17 assists, 22 points. Adam Dentenmeyer, 13-15. And then you have Patrick Pence, the only other Billiken in double digits with 3-8. You have Isaac Ryder with 5-3 for 8 points. Meanwhile, Joey McConnell has to make a save, and he'll hold on with 12:07 to go. The Ice Bears' leading scorers, Andrew Kovacic, 12-6 for 18 points. Zane O'Brien, 7-7 for 14. Jordan Bratton, 5-8 for 13. Travis Barrett, 7-5 for 12. Defenseman Brennan Anderson, 3-9 for 12. And then Josh Bell, 4-7 for 11, but he's not playing in tonight's game. Here's O'Brien with a drive in right through the midsection of Dirks. He'll hold on. 11:58 remaining in the period. And we'll have this face-off to Dirks' left. Shots are 10-2 in favor of Missouri State. Jordan Bratton comes in. He will try to win it from Niall Capron. And he does. Sent past O'Brien's skates. Now O'Brien picks it up. Well, unfortunately, he meets Capron, the captain. It's taken away and flung out to center ice. Here comes Pence left side. Nice move. Pence gets right through the slot, and it's broken up by the Ice Bears. Still with it is Capron. He and Pence help out. It's double teamed now on the Ice Bears defense. Goes to the left side. Colin Beschel with a drive through traffic. Deflected. The Ice Bears still with control. Get it over to the corner now to Travis Barrett out of St. Peter's. 4 goals, 2 assists for him. 11:20 to go in the period. And the Ice Bears work it out to center ice. Now across the line, moving it is O'Brien. He gets taken out of the play. Giving up his stick was Friend. And it is still in the St. Louis zone. Now both number 12s work with the puck. Dylan Kelly and Travis Barrett of Missouri State. Goes to the far side, taken by Patrick Pence. He's pulled off the play. Gunnar O'Brien steps in. Now the Ice Bears have it. Left side, tipped in front, and just missed. As the man waiting to tip it in front was Zane O'Brien. Open net to the corner, but a good save by Dirks. Now working hard is Blake Sabinski of Missouri State. Taken away by Isaac Ryder. He clears it all the way down. This is a slow rolling puck. No icing. 10:26 remains. Near side boards. Down in low in the Missouri State zone. Kelly had it, lost it, and it's out to center ice. Ice Bears with it. They'll shoot it in. Slow line change, no icing either. Davis has it for Missouri State. Davis works it around Tim Komet. Davis to the left side, dropping in low to hold it in. On the backhander is Alex Smith, and we get a whistle and a stoppage in play. Two Alex Smiths in this game. Missouri State's Alex Smith from Wichita, played for the Wichita Junior Thunder last season, the freshman of the Western States Hockey League playing for Missouri State. He has a goal and an assist. And then another Alex Smith, freshman. All right, take that back. He's a senior, 5'10", out of Coppell, Texas. He wears number 14 for St. Louis. Near side boards, Turin digs it out. But now that Alex Smith has it of St. Louis, can he clear it? No, but it's helped out by Luke Horn. Now to Smith. Cross ice pass, gets it up the middle. Broken up, good play there by Turin of Missouri State. Now the Ice Bears dig it out. They quickly get it up to center ice. Here's Turin. He'll send it in. Dirks can't cut it off. Near side boards. Goes past Kovacic. Stays in on the near side on the right point. Up on a backhander from McClue. Turin had it. And we come out the other way. Now right to left. Luke Horn with it. Horn drops it off to Smith. He shoots. It gets deflected up off of the stick of defenseman Brian Fuller. And with 9:11 to go in the period, we have no score here at MediaCom Ice Park. Shots 11-3 in favor of Missouri State at the first period intermission. Have a chat with the head coach of the St. Louis University Billikens and Sean Fitzpatrick, his first year with this hockey club. Billikens win the draw. They just sail it wide to Carter Alcock. Near sideboards, goes all the way around now. Cut off by Turkjelian. Near side boards, and it's out to center and shoved all the way around into the Billikens end of the ice for an icing call. 8:55 remains with that icing call, bringing it back into the Missouri State end. Steve Kasson, Alex Somm on Web Sports Radio's live TV and also on KBFL. Thanks for joining us. 8:55 to go and off the draw. Puck will be played by Missouri State. Anderson shoves it to the near side boards. Careens around the boards. Now moves back behind. Anderson is there. He gets pushed from behind. Play continues. Up the middle. It is broken up. Taken away by Missouri State. Lead pass. Here breaking in is Shane Thornton. Thornton gets a shot. And it goes to the left side. Tipped in front again by Thornton. And it just missed wide. Thornton drops it in low. Now Saunders will give it to Thornton. Sends to the far side. Broken up by Patrick Pence. And on the line but out to center ice. Missouri State sweeps it back in and they'll change up. 8:10 to go in the period. Puck cleared out to center. Now taken by Dettenmeyer. He'll send it all the way in and Missouri State will intercept. But they had a hard time getting full possession. They do now. 2-on-2 into the zone. Drop back pass. It'll go to Barrett. In front with a drive and a save. So Barrett and Bratton working things well in Missouri State. Gets close, but Dirks is able to hold on. 7:52 to go in the period. And off the draw, puck cleared to the corner and underneath Chris Brown and all the way down into the Missouri State end. Puck flipped off the boards by McConnell. Now back of the Missouri State net with 7:34 to go. Puck is stolen, but we're going to get a whistle for a stoppage and play and a penalty. It'll go against St. Louis. This one will get called against Xander Sisko. And Missouri State will go on another power play. So Xander Sisko gets called for the penalty. Missouri State coming into today's game, 25% of the power play, but they're 0-for-1 right now, working on two. Here's Brown. Sends it down in low, almost deflected, but here's McClure. He shoots up high. It was Charlie West who tried to clear the puck, and he couldn't do it, and McClure was able to get a shot. Now Brown right side, drops it to Turin right side. Left side, it goes into the corner. Now taken by Anderson. Left point Anderson calling for it is Brown. Right side, Brown with it. Tipped in front by McClure, just missing. Ice Bears work the power play for 1:26. Now sending it to Brown, that is from McClure. Tipped in front, score! Brendan McClure gets the goal. And it's 1-0 Missouri State. As the Ice Bears work that one to perfection. And if you're wondering why Brendan McClure was celebrating, that's goal number 5 for him this season, but it's been a while. I take that back. That's goal number 1 for him this season. What am I talking about? That is goal number 1 for Brendan McClure. I was looking at his stats from last season. He had 4 goals last season, so yeah, he gets goal number 1. And the Ice Bears take a 1-0 lead. We'll catch the call from Kevin Thurow. But it's
Missouri State Ice Bears power play goal scored by number 18, Brendan McClure. Assisted by number 27, Chris Brown. And by number 20, Andrew Kovacic. Time of the goal at 13:06 of the first period, scored on the power play by number 18, assisted by number 27 and number 20.
So the Ice Bears get that power play goal. They take a 1-0 lead on Brendan McClure's first of the season. So last year he had 4. He already has 25% more than he had last year. Puck sent down in low. He was injured last year too. So with 5:50 to go in the period, it goes to the far side. Working it is Dylan Kelly. He gets it out to center ice. Shots are 15-3 in favor of Missouri State. Puck to Fuller. That is Brian Fuller, and he's able to come out with it. Fuller gets it across the line into the zone. Before he gets hit, he sends it all the way down. Now worked by Max Battle to the near side. Stuck away from him by Luke Horn and out to center ice. sent right back in, and Missouri State will chase. 5:15 remaining in the period. Zabinski now is able to hold it in. Davis has it, but it's cleared all the way down. And we have an icing call. 5:06 to go on the period. And icing will bring it back into the St. Louis zone. With 5:06 to go and a 1-0 lead for Missouri State. McClue is first. Chris Brown and Andrew Kovacic with the assists. Off the draw, puck on a backhander sent wide by Lounder. Goes to the far side. Now it'll be Alex Smith with it. Gets it out to center ice. Lead pass coming all the way down. No icing. It's been waved off as racing for the Icebreakers was Patrick Johansson. We come the other way. Now across the St. Louis end. It'll be chased by Colin Beschel. He gets checked behind the boards. Icebreakers still working it, but taken away by St. Louis. Up the middle now. Pence. Turns and burns, comes the other way, across the line, tried to get it to Friend, broke it up. Now it's Niall Capron. Capron sends it down in low, works it behind the net. 4:24 to go. Ice Bears with three on the near side boards, are able to get it out to center ice just as far as the blue line as it gets deflected. And a good play by Pence to keep it in. Sent down in low, chased by Dentenmeyer. Far side boards, Ice Bears finally get it out of harm's way just enough to get it to neutral ice where it's intercepted by Friend. Blake Friend out of St. Peter's, Missouri, the sophomore, gives it back to his defense. Now work to Niall Capron out of Chesterfield, Missouri, the senior. Sent all the way around to the far side. Beschel with it, lets it go out to center ice. Sent over to Dentenmeyer on a cross ice pass. Now intercepted by Missouri State's Marshall Gevers. Gevers had a bouncing puck. Now Brennan Anderson to chase. Anderson dives, is able to knock it away to the near side boards with 3:30 to go in the period. 1-0 Missouri State. Ice Bears with an outlet pass broken up, taken away by Turkjelian, and we get a whistle for it offside. With 3:24 remaining in the period, make that 3:25 actually. Faceoff will come just outside the Missouri State zone. And off the draw, taken by St. Louis, sent in by Charlie West. Blocker save into the corner now. Spun around by Missouri State. They'll move it out to center ice. Now across the line, Anderson sends a pass over. Intercepted and brought out to center ice. Glove down by West. Put all the way down to the far side in the Missouri State zone where it's Nick Kervacucha to chase. Up the middle, Kervacucha had it, lost it. Still a bouncing puck, and it's taken away by Missouri State. Zane O'Brien is able to get it as far as the red line where Shane Thornton is trying to do his best to keep it going in a positive manner. Back down to the Missouri State zone. Ice Bears getting stood up with the neutral ice. Now cleared out to center. Sent right back into the Missouri State end by Carter Alcock. 2:25 remains in the period. Puck taken by Missouri State. They'll have it across the line. Now into the zone. Bratton lets it go. Picked up by St. Louis. They have a 3-on-2. Working this one is Isaac Ryder. But the Ice Bears come back. They catch up. They send it in and delayed offside for St. Louis. Slew to line change. Missouri State out of their own zone. Here comes Brian Fuller, F-U-H-L-E-R. We have another Dan Fuller on the team. He's F-U-L-L-E-R. Now here's Barrett, breaks free. Barrett, he shoots, he scores! Two nothing Missouri State as Barrett breaks through the defense. And Missouri State takes a 2-0 lead as Barrett just bowls his way through the defenseman. After stealing the puck on a second effort shot, scores.
By number 12, Travis Barrett. Time of the goal at 18:09 of the first period, scored by number 12, Missouri State.
So Travis Barrett with his goal number 5. As you heard from Kevin Thurl, it's unassisted. So the Ice Bears take a 2-0 advantage. McClue's first, Barrett's fifth. On the even strength goal. That one was deflected, and then Barrett, after a second effort shot, was able to put it in past Dirks. Now Turin has it, gives it to McClue. He shoots at an odd angle. Dirks makes the save, and the defense of Patrick Pence is able to clear it out to center ice. He'll give it to Capra. Left side now, sends it down in low. 2-0 in favor of Missouri State. It'll go to the far side, and the Ice Bears break out again. Across the line, too far for Brendan McClue, and it's cleared back into the Missouri State end of the ice. Ice Bears circling around. They finally get it out to center ice. Too far for McClue. Icing will be the call. 57 seconds left in the first period. Coming up at the first period intermission, a talk with the head coach of the St. Louis University Billikens and Sean Fitzpatrick. .1306, a power play goal, Brendan McClue. .1809, an even strength goal, Travis Barrett. And we're at 2-0. 52 seconds remains. Right side drive in and a save by McConnell as Tim Kemet got that one. Or Kemet, maybe. Behind the net. Ice Bears with 39 seconds. Can they clear the puck? Trying to work the puck again. Now with 23 seconds, Missouri State will hold on to things. Ice Bears lost the puck. Now Kemet, he'll have it right side. Looks in front, it's taken away in front, score! The puck was taken away, and right there was Nick Krivokucha to put it back. It's a 2-1 hockey game. And just a bad fortune for Missouri State, but a good fortune for St. Louis, as they are the recipient of a bad clearing pass, and Missouri State finds themselves with a 2-1 hockey game now. As the puck was stopped, it was cleared, but right into the skates. With 8.5 seconds left, they score. So Krivokucha gets the goal. That is his first of the season. And St. Louis gets a goal. That goal coming at 19:52.
At the end of the period, there is St. Louis University Billikens goal scored by number 28, Nick Krivokucha, assisted by number 17, Jeffrey O, and number 11, Tim Kemet. Time of the goal at 19:52 of the first period, scored by number 28, assisted by number 17 and number 11.
So the Ice Bears put 16 shots on Dirks. Joey McConnell faces just 4, but because of that strange situation there, gives up a goal. After Missouri State's Brendan McClue with a power play at 13:06, Chris Brown, that's his first, by the way, Chris Brown and Andrew Kovacic with the assist. Then it is Barrett with the goal. And Travis Barrett gets his fifth of the season on the second effort rebound, and Missouri State has a 2-0 lead. That comes at 18:09. Then, just moments ago at 19:52, it is Nick Krivokucha as the Ice Bears cleared the puck right into his skates, and Missouri State ends up right now with a 2-1 advantage instead of coming into the locker room with a 2-0 advantage. Shots on goal, as I mentioned, 16-4. Power plays, Missouri State 1-2. The Billikens have yet to be on a power play. Missouri State has not taken a penalty yet, so the only two penalties have been assessed to St. Louis. We will take a break, and when we come back, we will hear from the head coach of the St. Louis University Billikens and Sean Fitzpatrick. We'll do that in just a moment. After 20 minutes of play, it is a 2-0 lead. Excuse me, a 2-1 lead now for Missouri State. We'll be back.
Hi, my name's Scott Morris. I own Falstaff's Local. It's the new hockey bar in town. You're missing out if you don't come and watch some Blues games down here. You'll also be able to hear the sound of all the games. We're located between the Hers Building and the movie theater on Park Central West. We have a limited but great menu. We're open for lunch. We are the hockey bar, so come and watch all the hockey games. We're going to cover MSU Ice Bears, the Springfield Express, and we may have some big-time NHL players show up. We are installing a train whistle down here. I think we're the only ones in town that are daring to do that. Please come and see us at Falstaff's The Hockey Bar. Thanks a lot. I will see you soon.
We all love the fajitas. Their margaritas get the crown. Don't forget the quesadillas. It's the best Mexican food in town.
Now your favorite Mexican restaurant is open on Sunday. Yes, Maria's Downtown is open on Sunday. So bring your family and friends and enjoy Mexico with us 7 days a week.
Hold on to your salsa and your chips.
Maria's on South Avenue in downtown Springfield.
Now playing at MediaCom Ice Park in Springfield, a new ice age. It's the Missouri State Ice Bears hockey. Now through February, exciting, hard-hitting, fast-paced collegiate hockey, Ice Bears style. Get your advance tickets at Missouri State Ticks box offices or call 417-836-7678. Tickets also available at the games. There are no speed limits at MediaCom Ice Park when you see Ice Bears hockey.
Your best source for awards of any kind is always Bowles Trophy House in Springfield. Trophies, plaques, medals, gifts, ribbons, and more. You get top quality and great service at Bowles Trophy House, serving Springfield in Southwest Missouri for over 40 years. Call them at 417-869-8720.
And if you need embroidery work done, logos, digitizing, and more, come to Banners and Brainstorms in Bowles Trophy House at 601 South Kimberly.
Back to MediaCom Ice Park, Steve Cass and Alex Somm on KBFL and on Web Sports Radio. The head coach of the St. Louis University Billikens and Sean Fitzpatrick joining us. And Sean, obviously we don't see SLU much anymore as a Division II team, but right now 8-2, and you had big wins over Lindenwood, big wins against Iowa State. And all I can say is your team looks like it's no slouch this year.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate that. You know, this being my first year coming in, I kind of want to instill a hardworking mentality, and a lot of the guys have bought into that, which has been tremendous in making my job easy, and we've gotten good results from that.
It looks like you kind of have guys all over the board. You have a pretty good senior core. You have a good freshman core coming in, so it's kind of a mixture where you have that those returners that can kind of instill something, but you have those freshmen that are eager to learn too.
Yeah, so we've been very fortunate with our leadership group on our team. Our elder statesmen, our seniors, have done a great job of taking these new guys under their wing and kind of showing the ropes on, you know, how the league is, because coming in there's a lot of different rules compared to high school hockey or junior hockey. So showing them the finer points in the game and teaching them to be a good collegiate player.
Now, St. Louis University at one point years ago was the Division I squad. They dropped down, and they've really had all sorts of, you know, Todd Ewan was a former NHL player. They've had coaches like that. St. Louis has had some really good fortune come into their backyard, so to speak. And it's been tough because you have all sorts of other teams, Lindenwood, to name a few, and Lindenwood, Belleville, and now here you have St. Louis University trying to do something in ACHA hockey. But so far, the team has done the best it could, and with an 8-2 record right now, you can't ask for anything more.
Yeah. You know, like I said, I'm fortunate enough that our players have bought into my system right away, and that's made a great impact. And, you know, that's why I always preach whenever we do play Lindenwood Belleville or Lindenwood St. Charles there in McKendree, that we need to really put on a good show and get good results, because that's going to make this program grow and develop. Because for years we've been the bottom feeder for, you know, the St. Louis metro area for college hockey. But with beating McKendree and beating Lindenwood, and then we played Belleville to a one-goal game, I think kind of helps get our name out there and put our name on the map, so that way when kids in St. Louis are looking for options to play after high school, they'll definitely be starting to think about SLU rather than that being an afterthought.
Now, one thing that Missouri State is very familiar with is the Mid-America Collegiate Hockey Association, MACA. And, of course, winning a championship is a goal for this club.
Mm-hmm. Oh, absolutely. You know, we did split our weekend series with McKendree, and they won the MACA last year. They went 16-0 in the league, so they're, you know, undefeated. So for us to come out and beat them in one of our first games of the year really set the tone for what our expectations are and what our goals are.
Your club right now has almost scored twice as many goals as they've given up. So defensively, you're looking well, and offensively, it looks like you got guys that can put pucks in the net.
Yeah, I mean, we got a handful of guys that are just natural goal scorers, which is great. But unfortunately, those are the guys that I'm also yelling at to get back on defense more. I'm definitely a defensive first coach, and that mentality. You know, it's the old saying that defense wins championships. You only need one goal to win a game if you can stop, you know, keep them out from scoring goals. So that's what I've really been harping on, because we got a lot of guys that like to do fancy things in the end zone, on the offensive end zone, but kind of lack the responsibilities in the defensive end zone. So I'm trying to get them to be more two-way players.
Three guys really in double figures right now. You have Adam Dettenmeyer with 13 goals, and everybody else is hovering around 5-6 or so. And Nal Capron has 22 points, 17 assists, so he's dishing the puck a lot.
Yeah, he's passing the puck to Adam. That's why that Adam's got so many goals. You know, it's funny to see them work, because Niall's the hardest worker, and Dutch just, he just has that knack the guys have where he's in the right spot at the right time, and a puck just comes to him, and it's, you know, I'm scratching my head. How did he get that?
You know, it's nice to have that, but at one point, if it gets to where you have to depend on it, that's a little tough. So obviously you want the rest of the guys to start getting into the act.
Yeah, absolutely, and I've worked with Adam a lot on that. You know, those goals will come to you, but more goals will come to you if you're willing to work hard and put yourself in better situations. So, you know, and it was a struggle with him at first to buy into that, because he's always had such success, and now he's starting to realize, okay, if I work a little bit harder and I move a little more, I'm going to get open more rather than just standing there waiting for someone else to make a good play and get me the puck. So now he's buying in, and that whole line, that whole unit has just been absolutely tremendous for us this year.
Sean Fitzpatrick is the head coach of the St. Louis University Billigans, joining us on KBFL and on Web Sports Radio. And, you know, you look at your schedule, you mentioned McHenry. They have been one of those up-and-coming teams. They started out in Division III. They moved to Division II. And they still always had been that thorn in the side, no matter who was their opponent. And it seems like they still are.
Oh, yeah. I mean, they have a good program there. You know, they've established themselves. And like you said, going from D3 and then moving up to D2, they wasted no time to make a name for themselves, you know, going undefeated. They have a great program. They got a brand-new facility on their campus, which is tremendous. They're very well coached. And they're just a hard-working team. I mean, they got guys that come in there and just absolutely work as hard as they can. And that's what makes it easy as a coach. I'm sure their coach thinks so, too, because they get the results just from having guys that come out there and work as hard as they can.
This year you decided to start a little bit early, September 15th. Not that it's that early, but a lot of teams start play later in. But you get to play Bradley and you get McKendree early on, so it kind of tested this team a little bit right out the gate.
Yeah, that's definitely a challenge. You know, going to that Bradley weekend, that was our first league games, and it, you know, you're excited, but it is very early in the year, and you haven't had time to develop that team chemistry and see exactly what you got. So from a coaching standpoint, it was fun, because we got to see who worked well together, and we were shuffling things around. I'm sure the players were frustrated, because we ended up losing that first game, and you know, that's really just us trying to figure out what works.
If you look down the line at your roster, I mean, you got a couple of guys that are right around the 200, 235 range, 205. But majority of the players are, for all intents and purposes, just lean and quick, I assume. So how do you face some of these teams that might have bigger bodies?
I mean, I think that the way the game's shifting, it's more about speed and being able to maneuver around the ice rather than back in the day where you could just have a big lumberjack push guys around. You know, the way the game's played and officiated, you have the guys that are able to move their feet and move their puck. But there's still always going to be a place to have, you know, big, strong physical guys, because that's just the nature of competition, and especially in hockey. There's so many 50-50 battles where if you're bigger and stronger than a guy, you're just going to win that based on size and strength alone. But to be able to move your feet, that's the direction the game's headed, and that's what we're looking for.
5-1 away, and you've given up 16 goals. Really, that's the most you've given up as far as being on the road. You've only given up 9 at home, so obviously home is a good thing for you. Mm-hmm. But your first test here playing a Division I squad, what have you told the guys? What have you said as far as what type of play they should expect?
Yeah, I mean, through practice this week, I really preached to them that this team's going to be bigger, stronger, and faster than what we've seen. And that's just the facts of it, because they are a D1 team. They do have a better caliber of players on their squad. So I really just preached that, you know, we got to go in there and we got to match their intensity. We got to work as hard as we can. And we just got to be smart. You know, we can't get away from our game. We can't be selfish. We can't give up. At no point, you know, you can just let down and say we expect to lose. Because if you go with that mentality, you've already beaten yourself. So I've really just preached, we got to come in here and we got to try to steal a game.
Wouldn't that be something?
It'd be nice, but, you know. We'll
Sean
see.
Fitzpatrick joining us, the head coach of St. Louis University. Well, in a sense, you get to play Missouri State 4 times. Mm-hmm. Now, of course, you play the Division I squad this weekend, and next weekend at home, you play the Division III squad.
Mm-hmm.
So you don't actually play within your division. It's one up, one down. How do you get prepared? And I know I just asked you this question, but obviously you're going to get prepared for a bigger, stronger, faster Missouri State Division I squad. Then all of a sudden, next weekend, you have to prepare differently. So is it difficult for you as a coach to try to prepare for two different types of games, especially since they're in two different leagues?
Yeah, I mean, the way...
Or divisions, actually.
Yeah, the way we look at it on our coaching staff and what I said at the very beginning of the year, you know, I really don't want to change our game plan based on who we're playing against, because if we're doing everything right and the things that we should be, the other team should have to adjust to what we're doing. So, I really plan on coming in here. We're going to play our game to the best of our ability. And, you know, if we need to make adjustments, we'll do that. And then as far as next weekend, the same thing. You know, we need to play our game the way we play our game. And Missouri State's D3 team is no easy game. I mean, they were very, very highly ranked in Division III last year. You know, for example, they beat Iowa State last year, and Iowa State moved up to D2, and we barely beat Iowa State this year. We played them 2 weekends ago, and we won both games by one goal. So their D3 team is very competitive. We know that going into it. And looking at our score last year, we didn't kill Missouri State's D3 team. It was a very competitive, close game. So we're going to go into all four games with the same mentality that, you know, we need to play our game.
If you look at goaltending right now, Alec Dirks, your junior, and Kyle Bray, your senior, they've been around a while.
Yeah, they've been around. They've seen the league, so they know what to expect or what their expectations are from us, too. And, you know, I'm very fortunate that I stepped into this program and I had those two guys back there, because they're extremely competitive. They challenge each other, and they're very good friends. So friendly competition is always healthy competition. So they're always pushing each other and working, and that makes them better, makes the team better, and it's just a great situation to have both those guys back there.
You know, we've always said that you really want to build your team around your goaltending. Get your goaltending first, and then you have nothing to worry about. And that's really what it's been, and now it's just trying to figure out who you can get on the team. And as I touched on earlier, how difficult, or has it been difficult, to try to recruit?
It's been a little bit. You know, I'm still fairly new to this. We're very lucky being based in St. Louis. We have great high school hockey out there, so it's easy to talk to people. You know, I have good connections with a lot of the high school hockey coaches. I coached in the league for 5 years, so I'm familiar with guys. But it is tough selling the university. That's the hard part. You know, it's a pretty expensive private school, and you have other options locally that are much more affordable. So at the end of the day, when you're playing at this level in the ACHA, you're going for an education, and that's what we preach. And winning games makes it easier to recruit kids. So that's what we're trying to preach every time we're playing a series. We say the more games we can win, the easier it is going to be guys in here, and the better we're going to be off.
Well, Sean Patrick, the head coach of the St. Louis Billikens, you are 8-2 this season, so wins are definitely a good thing if you're trying to recruit right now.
Yeah, absolutely.
All right, Sean, good luck for the rest of the season. I tell everyone, you know, good luck except for these next two games.
Yeah, right.
All right, we'll take a break. We'll be back. Thanks for doing this.
Thank you.
All right, more hockey coming up in a moment on KBFL and on Web Sports Radio.
Hi, my name's Scott Morris. I own Falstaff's Local. It's the new hockey bar in town. You're missing out if you don't come and watch some Blues games down here. You'll also be able to hear the sound of all the games. We're located between the Hers Building and the movie theater on Park Central West. We have a limited but great menu. We're open for lunch. We are the hockey bar, so come and watch all the hockey games. We're going to cover MSU Ice Bears, the Springfield Express, and we may have some big-time NHL players show up. We are installing a train whistle down here. I think we're the only ones in town that are daring to do that. Please come and see us at Falstaff's The Hockey Bar. Thanks a lot. I will see you soon.
We all love the fajitas. Their margaritas get the crown. Don't forget the quesadillas. It's the best Mexican food in town.
Now your favorite Mexican restaurant is open on Sunday. Yes, Maria's Downtown is open on Sunday. So bring your family and friends and enjoy Mexico with us 7 days a week.
Hold on to your salsa and your chips.
Maria's on South Avenue in downtown Springfield.
It's time to drop the puck on the second period. Here's Steve Kasson.
Referees have made their way out onto the ice. And in moments, it'll be both teams as Missouri State has a 2-1 lead over St. Louis University. Brendan McClue on the power play back at 13:06, his first of the season. Chris Brown, Andrew Kovacic with the assist, 1-0 in favor of Missouri State. Then at 18:09, it is Travis Barrett. Barrett for Missouri State makes it a 2-0 hockey game. On a second effort after it was touched and deflected by the defense. And that defense was Carter Alcock. Then Missouri State finds themselves leading, that is, only by one, as the goal is scored by Nick Krevacucha. And Missouri State right now with a 2-1 advantage. Shot 16-4 in favor of the Ice Bears. And the Ice Bears this time will be skating from the right to the left. And we are moments away from puck drop. And off the draw, puck will be won by the Ice Bears, but quickly gobbled up by St. Louis and sent in off of the stick of Gunnar O'Brien. Cleared by Brendan McClue of Missouri State. It's out to center ice. And sent in by the leading scorer of Missouri State and Andrew Kovacic. Dirk stops it there. Now with 19:34 remaining, puck is cleared out and sent all the way down into the Missouri State zone. We're going to have an icing call. 19:30 remaining in the period. Icing will bring it back into the St. Louis end of the ice. Well, if you're St. Louis and your head coach Sean Fitzpatrick, that's what you want to see, is a goal late in the period. Krevacucha getting it. And Missouri State, now all of a sudden, it's a different game. Now you don't lead by two. Changes your philosophy. Meanwhile, the Ice Bears with Brendan McClue in a good opportunity on the right side. Anderson intercepts, held in by Kovacic. He drops it in low, gets it to McClue, back to Anderson again, left dot. He gets a shot, it's blocked. And sent by McClue along the goal line. He shoots, hits the post, rebound in front, save Dirks. Rebound again, Dirks, and it's loose. Ice Bears have it again. Anderson through some open, score! And Dirks is upset. Dirks feels there should be some kind of interference with that. He's yelling at the referee. But Missouri State, here in the second period, take a 3-1 lead. And we'll see if we can get a look at it. But Dirks is absolutely livid with the officials. He says that he doesn't think this goal should count. And we'll take a look. We'll see if we can get back to the initial series where the entire thing started. And it was McClue getting it low along the goal line. His first attempt hits the post. It's loose. Dirks thought he had it covered. The puck is still loose. They get it to Anderson on the right side. There's players in the crease after that. And Dirks is just upset, saying, what is going on here? But Missouri State takes a 3-1 lead. Let's catch the call from Kevin Thurl.
Missouri State goal scored by number 11, Brennan Anderson.
And meanwhile, St. Louis comes back to score while we're listening to that. So this is what you want to see from St. Louis. Just as Missouri State, right off the draw, the Billikens score again. This one comes from the corner, and it's just a deflected shot that goes in off of the stick of Atten Detmer, and we have a different hockey game here. It's now 3-2, and we'll get the scoreboard updated for you in a second.
Missouri State goal scored by number 11, Brennan Anderson. Assist pending on the play. Time of the first goal at 1:12 of the second period. Scored by number 11. That's a Missouri State Ice Bears goal!
And for Brennan Anderson, he gets goal number
four. St. Louis University Billikens goal scored by number 15, Adam Dettenmeyer. Assisted by number 2, Colin Beischel. Time of the goal at 1:30 of the second period. Scored by number 15, assisted by number 2.
And that's what we have right now, is a 3-2 contest between these two hockey clubs. Shots are 19-7. And St. Louis making a game of it. As you heard, the assist goes to Beischel. But Dettenmeyer with the goal, that is his 14th of the season. Now at 17:29, Ice Bears have it again. Tipped in front by Thornton and a save by Dirks. Rebound in front and cleared by St. Louis. They'll send it into the Missouri State zone. Drop down in low. Working it is Horn. Flipped to the corner. Spun around and sent down in low. Near side to Gevers, and he'll clear it out to center ice. Marshall Gevers of Missouri State looking for his first goal. He was injured after game number one. He is the Western Collegiate Hockey League Rookie of the Year a couple of years ago. Puck comes off the side of the boards, and it is covered by Joey McConnell. So right after Brennan Anderson gets a goal, and we'll see if we can shorten that series up for you a little bit. And we'll replay those here in a moment. St. Louis comes right back. In fact, they come just 23 seconds later to get a goal and make it a 3-2 affair. Near side boards, backhanded in, held by Alcock, sent down in low, taken away by Heiserote. He gives it to Davis. Davis's pass broken up. Anderson will pick it up. He'll shoot it in. Hits a skate, stays in up at the top of the right point, and intercepted. St. Louis with a lead. Dropping it down in low, comes to the side of the net. No icing. Anderson's there with it. Anderson gets upended. Far side boards. Working the puck. And trying to push it forward is O'Brien for St. Louis. Taken away by Missouri State. Zabinski didn't get it, actually. Lost it in his sights, and It was cleared out to center. 15:44 remains. Puck across the line, sent down in low. Anderson will let it go. Goes around to Dylan Kelly, who sends it to the corner, but Turin intercepts. Good forecheck. Now Beschel. He works behind the Missouri State net. 3-2. Puck as the Ice Bears cannot clear the zone. It stays to the right side. Now to the near side board. Heiserot gets it across to the far side. Puck is cleared out to center, taken away by Beschel. Banked up to center ice. Now Pence with it across the line as he gives it a friend. Up the middle once again to Capron and a score. It's a 3-3 hockey game. St. Louis, for all intents and purposes, won't go away. And the Ice Bears see this 8-2 hockey club really working the puck. And I don't know, we'll take a look at it and see. It was definitely a deflection. And I think they'll give it to Dettmeyer again. I think that'll be his 15th of the season. We'll wait and see. But that's what I believe they're going to call this. Is Dettmeyer's
goal. St.
Louis
University goal scored by number 16, Blake Friend. Assisted by number 3, Niall Capron.
Meanwhile, they score again as the Ice Bears can't clear the puck, and Niall Capron gets it. Capron scores the third unanswered goal for St. Louis University. This one comes at 5:23. As Missouri State having all sorts of trouble in their defensive end. And this one was an easy one for Capron. As the puck comes from behind the net. Off the initial backhand. Ice Bears just not able to clear the puck. So we go back to live action.
University goal scored by number 3, Niall Capron. Assisted by number 15, Adam Dettmeyer. And number 11, Tim Komet. Time of the goal at 5:23 of the second period. Scored by number 3, assisted by number 15 and number 11.
So Capron gets his 6th. And it is now more of an embarrassing thought for Missouri State, who are just having a hard time in their own defensive zone right now. It's a 4-3 lead for St. Louis. Meanwhile, puck behind the St. Louis net. And with 13:02 to go in the period, we get the whistle for a stoppage in play. Faceoff will stay in the St. Louis end. Meanwhile, with 13:02, the clock is not rolling. The clock is not rolling, and play continues. So St. Louis with possession of the puck. They bring it across in the Missouri State zone. And it'll be shot around the boards by Charlie West. Far side, out to center ice, and Missouri State's Anderson will send it in. And with 12:18 remaining, rushing in for Missouri State is Blake Sabinski. Let it go to the point to Heiserode. He shoots. It's blocked in front. Shots are 20-9 in favor of Missouri State, but they trail 4-3 in this hockey game. Puck cleared by Komet. He'll get it out to center ice. Works it down low. Gets it to the near side boards. Lounder is there. Anderson for Missouri State. Davis to dig it out. Good forechecking pressure by Pence. Now shot from the left side. Sent to the near side once again. Getting pushed down is the Ice Bears Lounder by Carter Alcock, and it's cleared out to center ice. 11:30 to go. We're not halfway through this game yet. Puck dropped in low. Davis will stop it. McConnell will stop it, that is. Puck tipped in front, and Anderson will clear it. Here's a lead pass. It is too far for Austin Davis, and icing has been waved off. Now the Billikens shoot it in. Max Faddle gets it all the way down to the far side. It is Brian Fuller for Missouri State. Puck clear to the corner. Davis is able to clear it out to center ice. Checking is Kovacic. Come the other way, right to left. Blast in, hit the post. Blake Friend hit the post. And it could have been a two-goal lead. Now we're going to get an interference penalty against Missouri State. Interference, or they're going to actually call holding. Anderson's going to go for holding. Not sure if I agree with that one. That's what the official says. So holding to Anderson. First power play now for the Billikens. First power play for St. Louis. On the power play, 13 for 53, 24.5%. Missouri State on the penalty kill, 14 for 65, 78%. They have scored one shorthanded goal. We'll see what Missouri State can do here. Fresh 2 minutes on the board to Anderson. Still going to take the draw for the Billikens is Niall Capron. He does win it from Shane Thornton of Missouri State. Now the power play. Right in the middle, it is blocked as Dettenmeyer got that shot, and it's cleared. .143 remains in this power play. Puck sent in by Friend. It goes to the near side. Blocked away from Pence and shoved out to center. Ice Bears steal the puck. They'll move it in. Thornton's the one that gets that in. .116 remaining in the power play. Broken up by Brown, swiped by Saunders. Moved into the zone and kicked to the corner. Nice move as getting taken away from the play was Thornton. He decides to go to the bench for a line change. 58 seconds remaining. Puck in the Missouri State zone. 9:33. Puck down in low. Now goes up high slot to Faddle. He gets a shot off, save McConnell. Over the corner to Capron. Capron is battling there with Sabinski. Sabinski is able to steal the puck momentarily. Good play by Capron. He walks in, he shoots, and a save, McConnell. So even with all that pressure, Missouri State still allowing players to walk right in. Low on the goal line. 30 seconds remaining in the power play. Right side to Komet. It's a delayed offside. So the Ice Bears have the ability to clear the puck. And Johansson will shove it all the way down. Puck hit Fottle. And here he comes across the line in the Missouri State zone, broken up by Heisero. Taken away and cleared. Power play is over. Anderson goes to the bench. Ice Bears get a man on. That is Kovacic. And puck to the near side now in the Missouri State zone. Dropped in low. Spinning around is Turkjelian. It goes to the high slot, tipped in front. And it's tipped away. That shot came from Friend. It's up the middle, and finally the Ice Bears move the puck. Turin has it. 2-on-2. Turin, he pushes his man out of the way. Turin with it. Backhander that misses wide. Far side board as the Ice Bears are line changing. Puck out to center. Brian Fuller is there for Missouri State. He'll chase it all the way down into his own zone. He gives up the puck, comes right up the middle, and it's broken up and cleared out to center ice. So the Ice Bears, again, having trouble in their own defensive zone. That has led to three goals. Back St. Louis has scored three straight to come back from a 3-1 deficit. They have now, they lead on the scoreboard. We'll go ahead and fix the scoreboard for you by a count of 4-3. Here in the second period with 7:28 to go in the period. Puck from the slot is taken by Barrett. Now we get a whistle and a stoppage in play for a little bit of an argument there. So the last goal was Capron's goal. Just able to spin it around. The Ice Bears just had all sorts of trouble. Meanwhile, with 7:14 remaining, Ice Bears tipped the puck in. That was by Zane O'Brien. It'll go to the point. Heiser up with a drive. It's blocked in front and cleared out in front of the Missouri State bench. Sent right back in. And all the way to McConnell, he'll hold on to that one. .652 remaining in the period. Shots are 20-12 in favor of Missouri State, but they do not lead on the scoreboard. They trail by a score of 4-3. They're giving the third tying goal to Blake Friend. He gets his first of the season. The assist will go to Capron. That was the one that was being announced when St. Louis scored again. Now puck comes into the St. Louis zone. Here's Gievers with it. He'll work it across the line, get it into Thornton. He shoots, it's blocked. Gievers to pick up the loose change. Sent down in low, 6:15 to go. Missouri State trails by one. Now Dan Fuller on the ice. F-U-L-L-E-R gets it to the point. It's underneath Brown and all the way down. It'll be chased by Anderson of Missouri State. He'll come back into his own zone with 6 minutes to go. Gets around a check of Dettenmeyer. Now all the way down to the St. Louis zone. This is no icing. Raced by Zabinski to keep it away from being icing. Ice Bears intercept. They have to wait till everyone gets onside. Cross ice pass. Zabinski will chase it. He's in the zone. He steps in front of Friend. Now it'll go to Zabinski on the ice to Dan Fuller. Fuller to chase. Intercepted by St. Louis. Near side board stays in with 5:28 to go. 4-3 in favor of St. Louis. Missouri State at a 3-1 lead, and St. Louis with three unanswered goals to take a 4-3 advantage. Puck across the line into the Missouri State zone. Capron had it. Now gives it to the trailer. Pence to Capron, and a save by McConnell.
Did you know that Civil Kitchen and Tap located in downtown Springfield on the square is owned before and after any ice beer game for great food and a great atmosphere. Civil Kitchen and Tap is a proud sponsor of the Missouri State Ice Bears. And fans, if you're taking
15, make that 5:13 to go in the period. Coming up at the second period of intermission, we'll have a talk with Allison Tuckness. She is the PR manager for Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks. Puck is cleared all the way down into the St. Louis zone. Ice Bears have it. Kovacic, cross-ice pass, gets it to McClue. He walks free. He shoots, and a save by Dirks. Rebound behind the net into the corner. Now to Fuller. Puck taken away from him and cleared out to center. Back down to the Missouri State end. 4-3 in favor of St. Louis. Puck is cleared all the way down. This will be an icing, except it's on goal, so it's waved off. 4:40 remains. Line change for St. Louis. Missouri State will do the same on the next rotation. Puck in front of the Missouri State bench. Taken now as Fuller intercepts a pass. Fuller waits. He shoots. It's blocked. He'll chase it from the corner as it was blocked behind the net. Now here is Turin. He shoots. It's also blocked. Puck out to center ice. Anderson will chase for Missouri State. 4:08 remains. Fuller back of his own zone. Fuller gets checked hard by Ryder. Isaac Ryder out of West Bend, a graduate student, moves the puck. Anderson steals. Fuller flips. Broken up. And it's Kovacic. Kovacic's pass is out the center, and it's cleared right back in. Anderson sweeps it to the far side. Now move to the point. Save by McConnell off of the initial shot from Colin Beschel. He goes to the bench. Now we get an ice bear upended, and we get a penalty. We get Anderson upended and then getting pushed as he was down by Gunnar O'Brien, and O'Brien's going to go. And they're trying to get him to go to the bench or to the penalty box. He wants to go to the bench, and referee Jason Carrera says no, it's a roughing call. Power play number three for Missouri State. Second power play, make that third power play for Missouri State. Ice Bears are 1-for-2. And off the draw, Missouri State, who came into this game at 25%, can definitely use one now. They have not scored. Take that back. They have scored one. The initial power play goal by McClue. That's been it. Now here's a shot in that misses wide after Zane O'Brien got the pass. High slot to Heiserow. It gets deflected up and out of play.
16:43 in the second period. 2 minutes for roughing.
So roughing is the call. And O'Brien goes. .253 remains here in this second period. A 4-3 lead for St. Louis. 1:30 to go on the power play. Steve Kasson, Alex Somm, thanks for joining us on KBFL and on Web Sports Radio. Near side boards, working it is Heiserot. That's as far as it goes, and the Ice Bears, out of neutral ice, will set it up again. Good forechecking pressure by St. Louis. Missouri State having a hard time getting it into the zone once again. Now they finally get possession. Here's a shot as it gets deflected in front. The initial shot came off of Johansson, and then it got deflected right in front, and it was cleared. St. Louis quickly gets their players on the ice. McClue to chase. He'll bring it into the zone. Here's McClue with it. Power play is 49 seconds. It'll go now, sent in low. Back to Kovacic on the left point. Once again to Turin. He switches, gets it to Kovacic. Cross-ice pass broken up by St. Louis. Kovacic will have it at the half boards. Kovacic still with it. 30 seconds to go on the power play. Gets it to Anderson. He waits. He shoots. He scores. A power play goal. And you could see that Anderson was looking at the upper right-hand corner. He knew exactly where he was going to shoot. And there was nobody there. And Anderson pegged the upper right-hand corner and gives Missouri State a power play goal. It's also a tie game. This one for Missouri State on Anderson's fifth goal of the season. It comes at 18-17. So Anderson will get the goal. We'll take a look at that one again, as Anderson really had all sorts of time. Nobody covering the corner.
Number 11, Brennan Anderson. Assisted by number 27, Chris Brown. And by number 20, Andrew Kovacic.
So it's Brown from Kovacic. Meanwhile, McClue comes in, and Dirks has to make a save with 1:11 to go. And now we have some pushing and shoving, and we've got a couple of players that are not happy. And we'll see if we get additional penalties here. Anderson gets pushed away. We'll probably get both. Anderson's going to go for Missouri State. And for St. Louis, going into the penalty box will be Isaac Ryder. Probably two each for roughing. That's four penalties, 8 minutes for the Billikens. Two penalties, 4 minutes for Missouri State. And 1:11 remaining in the period. So Missouri State, who at one point had a 3-1 lead, find themselves now tied with less than a minute to go in the second period. This is a 4-4 hockey game. Here's a 2-on-1 for Slude. Pass in front, drive, score! Komet! And Missouri State has given up another odd man rush and another goal immediately after they score. This one comes on a 2-on-1 rush. And there was only one man back. Nothing Joey McConnell could do. This one ...19-08. And it's now a 5-4 game in favor of St. Louis again.
Goal scored by number 11, Tim Komet, assisted by number 20, Brad Turgelian, and number 15, Adam Dettenmeyer. Time of the goal at 19:08 of the second period, scored by number 11, assisted by number 20 and number 15. Penalties on the previous play to Missouri State, number 20, Andrew Kovacic, to St. Louis University Billiken, number 7, Isaac Ryder. Both 2-minute minors for roughing at 18:49 of the second period. 2 minutes for roughing.
Well, those were the initial penalties, so it was a 4-on-4 goal that SLU gets. And we now have 11 seconds remaining in this period. Play comes down to the Missouri State zone with 3 seconds remaining. Puck right through the slot. It's deflected in front at the buzzer. And it's a 5-4 lead for St. Louis. 6 goals in this period. And as Missouri State has outshot St. Louis, 11 shots on Joey McConnell. He's have a two-period total of 15. He's given up 5 goals. Sean Fitzpatrick's goaltender, Alec Dirks, with 8 shots and a two-period total of 24. We'll go through the goals for you real quickly before we hear from Allison Tuckness. But we have to go back to 1:12 of the period, and that is when Brennan Anderson gets a goal for Missouri State, his fourth of the season, to make it a 3-1 game. And this is one that goaltender Dirks was just kind of really livid about. He really felt that there was someone in the crease, that there was a lot of traffic in front, that maybe the whistle should have blown. It did not, and it was 3-1. But then all of a sudden, St. Louis comes back just 20 seconds later, and it's Dettenmeyer's goal, or Dettenmeyer, wide open, and he gives St. Louis a 3-2 deficit at that point. And then it's Blake Friend. Friend with his first of the season, Capron with the assist, and all of a sudden this game is tied up at 3-3. Then at 5:25, it's Capron with his sixth, Dettenmeyer and Komet. This one just spinning around right in front, and again, Missouri State having a tough time clearing people out in front. But Anderson comes back for Missouri State, and Anderson gets a power play goal, his fifth of the season, and you could see he was just waiting for the upper corner on the right side. Brown and Kovacic makes it 4-4, and then just moments later, it is a goal by Komet, and Missouri State on Komet's second trail right now by the score of 5-4. Power plays. Missouri State 2-for-3 on the power play. There have been 4 penalties on the Billikens. Again, that was a 4-on-4 goal by St. Louis. And just 2 penalties on Missouri State. Both have been assessed to Anderson. And just 1 power play for St. Louis. So Missouri State with some things to talk about when they head into the locker room. And most notably, well, a couple of things. One, not playing down to your opponent. I think the Ice Bears are playing to the ability of St. Louis, which is not bad. St. Louis is doing what they need to do, and they are responding quickly. They are moving the puck well, but Missouri State just seems to not necessarily take the urgency right now, as St. Louis has a 5-4 lead in this hockey game, and Missouri State needs to shore up defensively. They're having a hard time moving the puck, clearing the puck, anything in their defensive zone. They're giving up second effort rebounds, and that's what's happening right now with St. Louis taking advantage of that. They lead 5-4 on only 15 shots in this hockey contest. So we will take a quick break, and when we come back, we'll talk with Allison Tuckness of the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks, BCFO. That's who we're doing this Cancer Awareness Night and Jersey Auction Night for this weekend. And we'll have a talk with her coming up in just a moment. 5-4 after 40 minutes of play, St. Louis on top of Missouri State.
Hi, my name's Scott Morris. I own Falstaff's Local. It's the new hockey bar in town. You're missing out if you don't come and watch some Blues games down here. You'll also be able to hear the sound of all the games. We're located between the Hers Building and the movie theater on Park Central West. We have a limited but great menu. We're open for lunch. We are the hockey bar, so come and watch all the hockey games. We're going to cover MSU Ice Bears, the Springfield Express, and we may have some big-time NHL players show up. We are installing a train whistle down here. I think we're the only ones in town that are daring to do that. Please come and see us at Falstaff's The Hockey Bar. Thanks a lot. I will see you soon.
We're back at MediaCom Ice Park. Steve Kasson. Now talking with Allison Tuckness, the PR coordinator of Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks. And Allison, since the last time we talked, your hair is different.
Yes. Yeah, I went through my own cancer battle last fall. So.
Well, you're better, I hope?
Cancer-free. Yeah, couldn't
Good.
Be better.
So, if you don't mind, tell us about what happened.
I actually just started getting really tired, got to a point where I was pretty lethargic, and thought maybe I was anemic based on some other symptoms, and turns out I was slightly anemic, but my white blood cells and my platelets were almost non-existent at that point. So it was diagnosed with leukemia the day after Thanksgiving last year.
And so now, not even Thanksgiving yet, and you're fine.
Yeah. Thank goodness for modern medicine. The type of leukemia I had 20 years ago was a death sentence, and now it's 95% cure rate. So
let's go through, and I mean, it's amazing because here you are, PR coordinator for Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks, and all of a sudden you find out that you have some form of it. But let's go through for people that are listening right now. I know you mentioned you felt tired and lethargic, but what were the symptoms, and kind of walk us through how you got your treatment? Because there might be people out there that think the same thing, oh, it'll get better.
Yeah.
And maybe this will spur someone on to get checked.
I really listened to my body. I was having a hard time healing. Leukemia is so different from breast cancer, but my signs were I was having a really hard time healing. I was bleeding a lot when I was bleeding. I had no energy. The day that I did check into the hospital, I was having a hard time getting out of bed, and I know my body, and I listened to my body, and I know the difference between tired and run down versus I had a cold that wouldn't go away. So it all kind of snowballed into something bigger is going on here. This isn't me. This isn't me being sick. So you really just have to listen to your body and know your body and know, you know what, it's better to get checked than it would be to say, oh, I can get through this. There's no one's going to judge you or there's no harm in saying, you know what, I think something's wrong and advocating for yourself and fighting for yourself.
Allison Tuckness, the PR coordinator of Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks, joining us. And we can say this is the same thing for breast cancer, for people, and I say people, because it can happen to men too. And
yes.
People don't realize this.
1 in 1,000 men will get breast cancer. 1 in 8 women.
And because of that, obviously get yourself checked. You can do self-exams.
Yes.
But I assume the same thing, kind of listen to yourself. What are some of the examples of people that listen to themselves and are now?
I think women who do self-checks, they do their monthly self-checks and they notice that something feels a little bit off. And they don't care that they're not in the sweet spot age range for what people expect the age range to be for breast cancer. They may not have a family history. It may not look like what breast cancer looks like when you Google it, but they know that something is going on. I've met a woman who is extremely young, didn't have what looked like regular breast cancer, but she said, you know what, something's not right with me. And she went in and, you know, caught her breast cancer. So just don't keep fighting. If someone turns you away, screening mammograms are so important. And if someone turns you away or if your insurance won't cover it, especially if your insurance won't cover it, call us. Let us help you because we know the importance of screening mammograms and how that can save your life.
What's the number for the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks if people want to give you a call?
417-862-3838.
And as we mentioned, prevention is the biggest cure, so to speak, because if you check it and catch it early, chances are everything's going to be good. It's those late stages where you should have checked
right.
that they're the most difficult.
Right, which is why we tell people who are in that 40 and older age range, get checked once a year. If you have a family history, get checked once a year. You know, don't. People get scared when they find things that they think are wrong, and a lot of people will kind of hide inside themselves rather than get checked because they're afraid of the answer. Whereas if they go and they get checked, it may be nothing, or it may be something that can be easily taken care of at that point in time.
Allison Tuckness, PR coordinator for Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks, is our guest. And Allison, you mentioned that if people have an issue, to give you a call. All of this takes money, so there obviously has to be a way that BCFO raises money. This is one of them here at MediaCom Ice Park. We have a jersey auction. And I got to say, this is probably one of the best jerseys, I think, that we've ever done. And they're all great.
I
they
agree.
Really
it's a
are.
It's pretty sharp-looking jersey, though.
But this one is probably one of the best. And, if you're listening right now, we have a Buy It Now $250 price. But you have to be here to get it. So if you're listening, come on down to the ice park and get it this weekend. Then we'll be auctioned off after the second period on Saturday or tonight if you're listening. So, but there are other alternative ways that BCFO raises money.
Sure. You can always give directly to BCFO. You can give in honor of someone, in memory of someone, or just a general donation if that's what you see fit. We have events all over Springfield. There are places all over Springfield that are doing events for us this month, especially being Breast Cancer Awareness Month, but also year-round. There are things going on. We have events through BCFO, which you can see on our website, which is bcfo.org. We always list all of our events. And follow us on Facebook, Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks on Facebook, and we will tell you what's going on around the city that is helping us out. We also need volunteers for events, especially in October. So if financially you're not able to help us right now, volunteering so that other people can help us is just as important to us as money, because we're a small office. So we need, any extra hands are going to be a big help for us.
And I know that you mentioned, obviously, if people need help, I'm all for stories. So give us a story about how someone got helped.
We have a woman who there's actually a story about her. And I don't want to say the wrong news organization. One of the news outlets just did a story about how her screening mammogram through Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks saved her life. She caught the breast cancer early enough that she was able to get the treatment that she needed to be cancer free, which is, that's what we want. We also have women who, Crystal tells a great story, our executive director, of a woman who the money that we were able to give was so helpful to her that because prior to us helping her through her breast cancer treatment with our financial assistance program, she wasn't even able to buy a gallon of milk for her kids because she wasn't able to work during her treatment. And because she wasn't able to work, money was obviously tight for her family. And we were able to step in and help and pay and cover some of the costs of her living expenses so that she could take care of her children, buy them their milk, and take care of herself without worrying about the financial burden it was having on her family.
Allison Tuckness, PR director or PR coordinator, could it be the same thing, the same difference, of the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks. So October, then I assume, because it's Breast Cancer Awareness Month, October is your main month for raising funds, or do you have it balanced throughout the year?
October's a pretty busy year, busy month, I'm sorry. The end of the year is also pretty busy for us. People with thinking about end of the year gifts, it's a great time to think about Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks, because breast cancer doesn't just happen in October. So we like to remind people that, giving year round is extremely helpful. We have an event in the spring as well, and a bike ride in the summer. So we try to stay top of mind to people to let them know that, just because it's not October doesn't mean that we don't need funds. The great thing about BCFO is 100% of the dollars that you donate not only stay in the Ozarks area in Southwest Missouri, but they also go directly to our financial assistance program and helping our mammogram program, because we have other means of covering our overhead costs. So we do not use any of our donation dollars to cover overhead costs. So you can be sure that that $100 you give us will cover the cost of someone's mammogram and nothing else. So
staff salaries, all of that stuff is all taken care of, and
yes, we have other ways of covering those costs so that our donation dollars go to exactly what the people want them to go to.
Are there any events coming up? Obviously, this is one of the biggest ones, but anything else coming up in the near future that you might want to talk about?
Let's see. We've got an event on Sunday at McAdoodles in Republic. They're doing a wine tasting, and their proceeds are all going to be going to BCFO. So if you enjoy wine, it's a great opportunity. You get your own etched wine glass as well when you go to that. Sky Zone is doing a day on Sunday. They're donating 50% of their jump proceeds to BCFO, and if you go and you wear pink when you jump, you'll get a pass to come back for 30 minutes free. So it's a great opportunity to not only help us out but get some extra jump time in as well. So those are the two other events that are happening this weekend directly. And next Friday is Boobapalooza, which is at Coyote's Adobe. It's a pancake breakfast. It's a lot of fun. There's a silent auction, and all that will help BCFO as well.
Probably the only one time you can actually say those two words together
and
get away with it. But the phone number again for folks that are listening and that missed it the first time.
Sure, it's 417-862-3838.
And is there an email address to get a hold of somebody?
If they are wanting to, they could email... Jill is our nurse, and it's jill@bcfo.org. They could email myself, A-L-L-Y-S-O-N, @bcfo.org, and we can definitely get them what they need and get them in touch with the right person.
Allison Tuckness, PR coordinator of the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks, joining us. And what got you involved prior to your issue? What got you involved with this organization?
Our executive director, Crystal Webster, actually recruited me, brought me on the team. It was an organization that I had always paid attention to and noticed. Breast cancer has always been something that I've focused on as a woman and as someone who's had family members in different capacities go through breast cancer treatment. So I think it's one of those organizations that everyone can relate to, because I don't think there's anyone out there anymore who doesn't know someone who's been impacted by it. And I love what they did. I love the fact that the money is staying local and you can see where your dollars are going and you can meet the people and shake the hands and hug the people that are getting the help that they need.
Allison Tuckness joining us. Allison, one more time, the phone number for folks that may want to call.
862-3838.
All right. Allison, thanks so much for doing this, and
no
I'm
problem.
Glad that you're back on the road
Thank
to recovery.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
All right. We'll take a break. Be back. More hockey coming up in a moment.
Now playing at MediaCom Ice Park in Springfield, a new ice age. It's the Missouri State Ice Bears hockey. Now through February, exciting, hard-hitting, fast-paced collegiate hockey, Ice Bears style. Get your advance tickets at Missouri State Tix box offices or call 417-836-7678. Tickets also available at the games. There are no speed limits at MediaCom Ice Park when you see Ice Bears hockey.
Let's head for the third period. Here's Steve Kasson.
A 5-4 lead for the University of St. Louis, or St. Louis University Billikens, that is. Goals in that second period. Anderson for Missouri State is fourth. Dettenmeyer, he gets his 14th. Blake Friend gets his first. Niall Capron gets his sixth. Anderson comes back for Missouri State on the power play with his fifth, and then Tim Komet with his second on a 4-on-4, that coming at 19:08 of the period, and 5-4 is where we are right now. Missouri State getting themselves back ready, and again, these are not their normal uniforms. They will be back in their normal uniforms next weekend, but These are for breast cancer awareness, and they will be auctioned off, as you just heard from Allison Tuckness. It's to benefit her organization, the Breast Cancer Foundation of the Ozarks. As you take a look at those really, really nice jerseys, I think these are some of the best ones that we've done. That's the third or alternate third logo for Missouri State. Ice Bears will be skating from the left to the right, and the Billikens from the right to the left, and off the draw, the puck will be quickly into the St. Louis end of the ice. It'll be taken by Dettenmeyer. He gives it back on defense to Tim Komet. He has his second goal of the season now. Puck comes in the Ice Bears zone, and the first shot of the third period by Friend is saved by, and I believe that is McConnell. It still is McConnell in the nets. But because the net was dislodged, the faceoff will come outside the zone. Keep in mind, there's 29 seconds that remains in the 4-on-4. Puck will be Friend's to send it all the way in. Now we get a whistle, and Friend's stick is knocked away from Brown. And Missouri State out of their own zone. Brandon Anderson, as a line change ensues for St. Louis. Anderson, nice move, gets behind the net. Anderson tries to work around Friend. Anderson is double teamed. Tries to stick it in the corner. Turin to help out. It's now 5-on-5 as both players have come out of the box. They join the play. Goes to the point. McClue now becoming the point man, that is. Turin back to McClue. He overruns it. Puck is still in the zone. Now taken away by Smith. He shoots it in. McConnell will hold on to that one.
Fans, your attention, please.
18:50 remaining in the period. A 5-4 game in favor of St. Louis University.
Overtime winner of the 50-50 raffle. That is ticket number 858.
Shots are 24-17 now, so they are evening up just a little bit. The only two shots registered on Missouri State. Puck is sent in. Here's a lead pass coming all the way to Barrett. It's swept away into the corner. Now to the near side. Faddle lost it. Ice Bears with some pressure. Goes behind the net to Kolstock. He moves it into the corner. Now taken by Smith. He clears it out to center ice. :18:24 to go in the period. Puck sent all the way down, and we should have no icing. Line change for Missouri State. Play continues with 18:14 to go in the period. Puck to the near side to Faddle. He'll get it out to center ice, where it'll be dropped by Dylan Kelly at a Castle Pines, Colorado. Sends it all the way in, and it'll be stopped by McConnell. :18:03 remaining in the period. And the puck is at center. It's cleared all the way down. 17:51 remaining. Ice Bears steal the puck. They're behind the net. Goes to the corner to Brown. Sends it down in low. Cross ice pass. Nobody there. It'll be chased down by Brown. That was actually Johansson at the point. Brown drops in low, up the middle. Now it's off the stick of Gevers behind the net. Working it is Saunders of Missouri State. Puck to the point and off of the skate of Brown and all the way down. Puck comes into the St. Louis zone. Shot sails wide by Brown. Goes across, and Turin gets knocked down. We're going to get a penalty. It goes against St. Louis. That was actually Zabinski that got knocked down. Penalty against the St. Louis University Billikens. We'll have a tripping call, and Missouri State will go on the power play. And earlier, I believe I said that Anderson was called for the penalty. It was not Anderson. It was number 10. Turin. So Turin was the one that was called, and he's the one that came out of the box earlier. Power play number four now for Missouri State as Beschel goes in. Here in the third period, and Missouri State with a golden opportunity, and they get it cleared immediately. 83.6% was the penalty kill for St. Louis coming into today's game. Here comes Anderson. He shoots. It's partially blocked. Anderson again. It's a loose puck, and Anderson falls down on the puck in the crease, but he was upended in the crease, so we'll get no penalty. It was stopped by the goaltender. Dirks holds on. .1639 remains in the period, and Missouri State with .139 remaining in the power play. Turin comes in to take the draw. He'll win it. Chases it behind the net. Gives it to Kovacic. Looking to the point. Get it to Anderson. Over to Brown on the power play for .128. Drops in low. It's intercepted, though. Taken away and cleared. 16:20 remaining in the period. Puck at the Missouri State zone. They are having a lot of trouble getting it out of their own zone. Here comes Kovacic. He breaks free. Kovacic with a bouncing puck, and he gets in an opportunity. Dirks makes the save. Puck is cleared out to center. 55 seconds to go on the power play. Ice Bears have to clear the zone. They do. Now here comes Brown, left side. Brown spins it over to Turin. Turin waits. He shoots. Save Dirks. Rebound loose. And who's got it? And it's underneath Dirks, but pushing it forward was Blake Friend. And the officials do not, or are they talking over a possible penalty shot? At this point, they are not going to call it. Fans yelling for a penalty shot, but that is not the case. .1542 remains here in the third period. We are in the third. O'Brien will send it down in low. He gets a return pass. It's shot and blocked by Ryder. Goes to the far side with .1529. Ice Bears work 27 seconds left in the power play. Heiser over the shot. It's blocked. Goes through some skates. Goes to the point to Johansson, and he lost it. Taken away by Ryder. He's one-on-one. Ryder shoots, and he scores! A shorthanded goal. It's a 6-4 lead for St. Louis. The shorthanded goal is just the, well, it's just the fourth shorthanded goal Missouri State has given up. 4:45, the time of the goal. And it's 6-4 in favor of St. Louis. We'll get a look at that one coming up. Here comes Brown, tipped in front. O'Brien, rebound in front, score! It was knocked in by Dirks. So Dirks knocks it in inadvertently, and it's a 6-5 game. This one, moments later, at 5:04, and we'll take a look at this one, but it was Dirks who knocked it in off of his blocker, and that's where the goal comes from. As the shot comes in, and Dirks just knocks it in off of the blocker himself and into the net. We'll catch the calls here in a moment from Kevin Thurl.
St. Louis University goal scored by number 7, Isaac Ryder. Scored at 4:45 of the third period, shorthanded by number 7, assist pending on the play. Missouri State goal scored by number 12, Travis Barrett. Time of the goal at 5:04 of the third period, assist pending, scored by number 12. That's a Missouri State Ice Bears goal!
So Barrett with the goal, that is his 5th of the season. He's the last person to touch the puck. Meanwhile, we get a whistle for a stoppage in play and an icing. Faceoff will come back down to the St. Louis end of the ice. So Ryder gets a goal. And then Missouri State comes back on Barrett's goal. And it's now a one-goal hockey game. Here comes Kovacic. He almost stole the puck. It is stolen, though. Here's McClue with a drive in and a save by Dirks. We'll go back to both of those goals. Here's Ryder's goal. This is the first one. And he's just shooting it on goal. That's what you're supposed to do. And it goes off of the glove of McConnell and into the net. And at that point, it's a two-goal advantage for St. Louis. Then the Ice Bears come back as Dirks hits it in after the Ice Bears' initial shot, and they're going to give that initial shot by Travis Barrett. And that's where we stand right now, a 6-5 hockey game. And I'm sure if you're head coach Jeremy Law, you're wondering, why is it 6-5? It shouldn't be. But if you're head coach Sean Fitzpatrick, you're saying, we knew it all along. He knew his team could do this. Told his team during practice the whole time to stay prepared. Anderson puts a hit on Ryder, and now we get a whistle and a stoppage and play for the puck down in low. But Fitzpatrick told his team, get prepared, get ready. We'll work this just like it's any other hockey game. And they have been game this entire contest. 31-18 are the shots and a 6-5 lead for St. Louis. Lots of goals in this game. Puck is taken briefly by Missouri State's Blake Zabinski. Now the Ice Bears get it out to center. Big hit on Thornton as it's subbed down in low. Now here's Davis with it. He shoots, he scores! So Davis ties it up. Austin's second goal of the season. And it's a 6-6 hockey game. Davis threw some traffic on the right faceoff dot. Picks up the puck after he gloved it down and gets it through a lot of traffic past Dirks. And Missouri State has clawed their way back after having a 3-1 lead. It's now a 6-6 hockey game. This one at 6:48. It is Austin Davis's second goal of the season. We'll catch up with the assists in a moment. But 6-6 here at MediaCom Ice Park.
Missouri State Ice Bears goal scored by number 71, Austin Davis. Time of the goal at 6:46 of the third period. Assist pending on the goal scored by number 71. That's a Missouri State Ice Bears.
Well, what that means is it's happened too fast for the officials to keep up with it. Austin Davis gets the goal. Meanwhile, the Ice Bears come into the St. Louis zone. Barrett with a drive in after O'Brien was able to tip it away. And it's held by Dirks. 6-6 between Division I Missouri State, number 22 in ACHA Division I, and the St. Louis University Billikens, who are 8-2 this season. Now, computer rankings for Division II do not go out until November. So right now, St. Louis with a good showing in ACHA Division II. Puck flip down to the Missouri State end. 12:20 remaining in the third period. Puck is cleared out to center. Grabbed by Beschel and shot right back in. Capron steers it to the corner, looks for a wraparound, gets it right in front, and it's deflected. And we have a new goaltender. A new goaltender in nets for Missouri State is Brendan Shuck. Meanwhile, we get the puck chopped away. Brendan Shuck is in nets for Missouri State now. Or I take that back. I think it's Griffin. That's Brady Griffin in nets, not Shuck. Griffin, the southpaw, makes his first save. Puck to the corner. Now cleared out. So a 6-6 hockey game, and I believe after that last goal, by Isaac Ryder, it was Griffin in the nets. That one was the shorthander at 4:45. Now we get a whistle and a stoppage in play as Griffin is able to hold on to the puck. Shots 33-20. Griffin making just his second start of the season, or second, he's appearing in his second game of the season, that is. Made his first start, he won his first start. He's 1-0. Meanwhile, here come the Ice Bears again. Gievers races down the left side. Helping out is Hunter Saunders. Scrum behind the net, it comes out to the left side. Ice Bears work it down in low, get it to Thornton, who moves it to Gievers. Now Gievers gets pushed in hard. Puck is flipped up and cleared out by O'Brien all the way in. Quickly, Ice Bears tip it into the zone. Thornton is able to get it in. And it's dropped down where Missouri State will finish up a line change. Puck out to center. Sent over the far side. Now rung all the way around. Near side boards. Barrett is there to cut it up. Bratton will help out. Taken away by Carter Alcock. Lead pass comes all the way down. This is no icing. It's waved off. Now steering it right through the slot was Kolstock. It comes right up the middle. Saved by Griffin. Rebound in front. Taken away. And here come the Ice Bears. They race with 9:51. Barrett across the line. Barrett's pass gets broken up. It's taken away. Kolstock with it. Lost it, and a line change for St. Louis. Puck sent all the way down to the St. Louis end of the ice. Racing hard is Beschel. Gets it to the far side. Puck cleared to the corner and out to center ice, and it'll be raced by the Ice Bears defenseman and Patrick Johansson. Out of Saranda, Sweden, looking for his first goal is the sophomore. Ice Bears finish up their line change. 9:21 to go in the period. Puck now to Beschel. Gets it up to center ice. Torin gets in a field. Play continues. Here comes Torin. Torin to McClue. McClue right side. He shoots. And he got the shot off. But a huge save in front by Dirks. And he deflected it just wide of the net. It looked like it was going five hole. And it got deflected wide of the net. Now we get a whistle for a stoppage and play. There's a player down in front. And we cannot see who it is from our vantage point. And still do not know who that is. Trainers come out right out in front. But the Ice Bears have tied this hockey game on a goal by Davis, who gloved it down from the corner, got it over the shoulder of Dirks. And we'll see if we can take a look at the interference play. First, there's the interference. Okay, there's the hit, and there's the interference play. The initial hit, as we do get an idea of who it is, it looks like it's Beschel, and he gets up. Looks like he's okay. So we get to see both on that play. Good camera work there, Alec. It's both. Take a look at that one more time so you can... You see Beschel, he's the one that gets hit, and then there's the play of the interference at center ice. So in case you haven't looked at it, go to YouTube. Alec, A-L-E-C-S-A-H-M, does camera work for me. Also has some great videos on YouTube. .907 remaining in the third period. And Missouri State, who had as much as a 3-1 lead, have trailed since that point in time. That was the beginning of the second period. They have not led this hockey game since. And now we're at 6-6. McClue for Missouri State on the power play. Travis Barrett. We'll catch up the rest of the goal scorers as the Ice Bears have it. It comes right in front of McClue, and he shoots and a save. Dirk's rebound. Ice Bears work it again. They're trying to take the lead here. They'll drop it down in low. It goes to McClue again. Behind the net is Kovacic. Puck taken away, held in. No, it's not. Johansson delayed offside. Puck cleared out to center, and Missouri State with control again. They work the puck and send it in, and it's dropped down in low. Chasing it. For St. Louis is Komet. He has a goal. Now taken by Charlie West. Lead pass goes to Dettenmeyer. He shoots and it's blocked in front. Puck clear to the corner. Out to center ice. As far as the red line, and it's regrouped by Komet. Move to the right side. Save by Griffin. And behind the Missouri State goal line. Puck comes up to the Ice Bears, trying to catch St. Louis in a line change. Here's Turin, lead pass to Kovacic, back to Turin. Left side, Turin moves in, he gets in front, shot, and that's a goal. That should be a goal. It hit the inside of the pad. We'll see if we take a look at this again, but that shot, I believe, hit the inside of the pad, and I know that the officials are going to talk this over. But we'll see if we can take a look at that one. Here's the initial shot, and it hit the inside of the pad. We'll see if we can slow it down for you and take a look at that one more time. Well, maybe it hit the post. It's hard to tell. We'll see if we can get it even slower for you here. And they're going to call it a goal. Well, it's hard to tell. As you get argument now from Carter Alcock, arguing with the officials. But Missouri State has scored a goal. At least according to the officials. We'll take a look at it one more time in slow motion. Now, initially, it looked like it hit the back of the pad. Here, it's hard to tell with that bounce. But Missouri State gets credit for a goal. This comes at 12:06 of the period.
We'll catch Missouri State goal scored by number 20, Andrew Kovacic. Time of the goal at 12:06 of the third period, scored by number 20, unassisted on the play. That's a Missouri State Ice Bears goal.
So Kovacic will get goal number 13. And Missouri State has taken their first lead in this game on kind of a somewhat controversial goal. but Kovacic gets credit. Meanwhile, with 7:08 remaining, puck is in the Missouri State zone. Ryder, he gets a shot off. It goes behind the net. Griffin is there to make the save. Slides over to the right side. Now it is still held in. Dropped in low, taken by Friend. Friend hit the goalpost earlier in what could have given St. Louis a three-goal advantage. And here comes Missouri State. They quickly outlet it to center ice. Across the slew line by Fuller. That's Dan Fuller. And that's as far as it goes. Zabinski to forecheck. Missouri State up 7-6. They had not led since 1 minute into the second period. Blocker saved by Griffin. Goes to the far side. It's behind the net. Worked into the corner now. Chasing it for Missouri State is Travis Barrett with 6:20 to go in the period. And a 7-6 lead for Missouri State. Goals by McClue, Travis Barrett. Then by Krivokucha for St. Louis. Missouri State came back with Anderson. Then Detmeyer for St. Louis. Friend, Capron, Anderson back for Missouri State on a power play to make it 4-4. Komet makes it 5-4 in favor of St. Louis. Then a shorthanded goal by Isaac Ryder. That chases starting goaltender Joey McConnell. Then the Ice Bears have now come back with three straight on Travis Barrett's fifth, Austin Davis' second, and Andrew Kovacic is 13th. So the Ice Bears come back from a deficit of 6-4 to lead 7-6. This has been one of those wild hockey games. With wild lead changes. Now right off the draw, a shot that's partially blocked as Detmeyer was looking for another goal. Puck taken away by the Ice Bears. Here is Kovacic. He has it blocked and poked away from Charlie West, but it's back down into the St. Louis zone. Puck cleared all the way down. Tipped in by Pence. He's going to chase it, but stepping in front of him is Brown. He'll get it to the near side to Johansson. 7-6 in favor of Missouri State. Not really any implications for Missouri State as they're playing a Division II squad, although for St. Louis, lots of implications if they can beat a Division I team. In the midst of coming off of a sweep of Lindenwood Division II and a sweep of Iowa State Division II. Whistle for a stoppage in play. Faceoff will come just to the right of the goaltender. So Joey McConnell leaves facing 18 shots. Meanwhile, Gevers is roughing it up on the far side. Saunders comes in to help out, taken away and dug out by O. That's Jeffrey O. Now O with another shot that's partially blocked in front. 4:40 to go in the third period. Missouri State leads by one. Sent down in low. And if you like what you're seeing tonight, head on out to the Ice Park tomorrow. These same two teams, 7 o'clock right here in MediaCom. Puck up the middle. Now through the left side. It's partially blocked on a spinning Saunders. To the point. And still a scrum for it at the point. Now we get a whistle for a stoppage in play. Faceoff will come outside the zone, I believe. Referee Jason Carrera, Craig Smith, and Mark Marzola are the linesmen, and Marzola will drop it outside the line. I'm Steve Kasson along with Alex Somm. Thanks for tuning in on KBFL and on Web Sports Radio. We'll have another one for you tomorrow from the Stan Melton Ice Rink here in Springfield, Missouri. Scrum at the dot. It's won by Missouri State. Fuller is able to clear it, but he clears it up into the bench. Faceoff will come back into the Missouri State end of the ice. .401 left in this period. And off the draw, the Ice Bears do get possession. They break a 4-on-2, but they're slowly getting it established. Now they come across the line offside. You could see that one developing as it was slow to get going. And they bring O'Brien offline, or offsides, that is, with 3:50 to go in the period. Faceoff comes outside the zone. And O'Brien is able to steal the puck, is racing hard to do something with it, was Max Fattel, and the puck is cleared out to center ice. Now in front of the Missouri State bench. Ice Bears have it across the line. Barrett, he tried to pick it up. Knocked away from him and shoved out to center ice. Back in for Johansson. He shoots it into the corner. Now from the far side, it's behind the net. And Alcock out of Parker, Colorado. Ice Bears with 3:09 remaining. Bouncing puck steered aside by Griffin. He came in relief of Joey McConnell, who at one point had given up a shorthanded goal. Here comes the Ice Bears. Turin, as he came in the zone, he was trying to get behind the defense, and Friend is able to catch up. Now Missouri State has it again. Kovacic lost it. It's broken up, taken away, and here's a lead pass. It'll go to Capron. He breaks in left side. He gets to try to get a shot off, and it gets deflected into the corner. Puck sails wide of Griffin once again. Desperately trying to tie this game up is St. Louis. A shot in, snap one by Friend, is deflected to the near side. Puck played by McClue. It's out to center ice. Kovacic pushes his man. Now coming in is Austin Davis to move the puck. Davis with it again, broken up, and tipped in by Kovacic. Line change for Missouri State. Drop down in low. Davis will chase. He's 1-on-2. Now it's Komet. Fans starting to yell, "Let's go Bears." 1:49 remaining. Here comes O'Brien. He gets it into the zone. We'll wait to see if they pull Dirks or not. Does head coach Sean Fitzpatrick. Puck taken away by St. Louis. Now here comes Alcock. Dirks coming out as the shot gets deflected up, and I meant he was just coming out of his crease as the puck gets deflected up and out of play. He's not coming out of the net yet. But we'll see. With a timeout being called by St. Louis, what they do in the faceoff in Missouri State's end of the ice. While they take a timeout, we will take a quick timeout, and we'll be back for the last 1:30 of regulation. It's 7-6 Missouri State.
Now playing at MediaCom Ice Park in Springfield, a new ice age. It's the Missouri State Ice Bears hockey. Now through February, exciting, hard-hitting, fast-paced collegiate hockey, Ice Bears style. Get your advance tickets at Missouri State Tix box offices or call 417-836-7678. Tickets also available at the games. There are no speed limits at MediaCom Ice Park when you see Ice Bears hockey.
Back at MediaCom Ice Park, Steve Cass and Alex Somm on KBFL and on Web Sports Radio. As tradition here,
hands, touching hands, reaching out, touching me.
Sweet Caroline played here at MediaCom Ice Park. Meanwhile, puck is won and sent all the way down into the St. Louis zone with 1:23, but we get an icing call. And I think the argument is that there was a race to the hash marks. That's what head coach Sean Fitzpatrick is asking. Why? Let's take a look at it real quick if we can. And he's right. He's absolutely right. There was a race to the hash marks. Meanwhile, puck is taken away, and it is at the line, but now with 1:05 remaining, we'll see if they pull Dierks or not. St. Louis with possession, and it looks like he's going to go. Once St. Louis gets possession in the zone, they do. Here's a drive-in blocker save. As Fadel got the blocker save. Empty net. The goaltender's been pulled. St. Louis with an opportunity on the right side. Blocked down in front. There's an ice bear down covering the puck. That's, I believe, Johansson. And now we get pushing and shoving with a couple of players getting caught into things here. Now the official's trying to break up a couple of other players, and who's going to get called this time? Johansson. That's not Johansson. That's Saunders. 25. From Missouri State, that is just their third penalty of the hockey game. Now with 44.4 seconds left, faceoff then should stay in the Missouri State zone. St. Louis, with the goaltender pulled, will have a 6-on-4 with the empty net. And is Missouri State going to get more? Are they going to get... There are two men in the box. Brendan McClue is talking with the referee, Jason Carrera. It's 7-6 Missouri State, but the Ice Bears have two men in the box. It's very likely this could be a 6-on-3. But nothing's been put up on the board yet. Now, if a player gets escorted to the dressing room, and that's not the case, so they're going to bring one man out, which is Saunders, who originally was told he's going to the box. So it's Johansson. The only penalty will be Johansson then, not Saunders.
Penalty on the play to Missouri State Ice Bear number 25, Hunter Saunders, for delay of game at 19:16. Correction there.
No, it's Johansson.
Penalty to number 58, Patrick Joe.
So now with the, it's a empty net and a backhander in, just missed wide by Kovacic. 36 seconds left. It's an empty net. So a 6-on-5. Make that a 6-on-4, that is. Here coming in is Capron. He shoots. It's blocked in front. Now with 24 seconds left. Ice Bears up by one. Cross ice. It is intercepted by Torin. A backhander in. It's going wide of the net. This is no icing. The Ice Bears are shorthanded. 13 seconds. Kovacic to forecheck. Puck is a delayed offside. The Ice Bears, Anderson has possession. Anderson with 5 seconds, and that should do it. 2 seconds, and as St. Louis is offside, Missouri State wins this hockey game. It was a very close game with wild swings between goals, but Missouri State comes out on top. Shots on goal in the third period, 10 on Dierks, for a three-period total of 34. And for St. Louis, they put a total of 26, 11 in the third period, with seven of those being recorded on Brady Griffin. McConnell faces 18 shots. Make that eight shots actually on Griffin, because McConnell faced 18, Griffin with eight for a three-period total of 26. Power plays, Missouri State was 2-for-4 on the power play. And the Billikens were 0-for-2 on the power play. They still had time as the clock expired. They had time on that penalty. But right now we have the Steak and Shake player of the game and Brendan McClue. And Brendan, it was obviously a while before you scored your first goal, and boy, were you happy about it.
No, that was fun. Getting into the second game, first game at home for the season, it was fun. Definitely get the power play going. Brown gave me a great pass. I mean, if I would have missed that, I would have sat myself. So nice to be down here on the ice rather than up there with you, though, Kasim.
It is, isn't it? Because you spent many a time up here surveying the ice.
Too much.
So being on the ice yourself, I mean, we could talk about this game, obviously against a Division II squad. You look at the score and you say 7-6. So did Missouri State, and I'll ask this, did Missouri State take this team lightly, or is this St. Louis team just as tough as they seem to be?
They're a tough team. I mean, they're 8-2 at Division II right now. So, I mean, they're not a bad team. We just had some mental breakdowns and defensive zone gaps. So we just got to tighten that up and come back tomorrow.
What will the Ice Bears do tomorrow when they face this team?
We're going to be a lot of dump and chase and just getting the work. We're faster than these guys. We just got to use our speed a little bit more, you know. We're more the more skilled team. They just outworked us a couple times tonight. So we got to get in the corner and win some battles and get to work. And I think it'll be a much different game tomorrow.
One last question, and this will be a fun question. What do you think of those jerseys?
Oh, these are sick. I like the alternative logo to this year. That's nice. Like them a lot. The new warm-up jerseys look good, too. Did you see those?
They are very good. I like those, too. So the question is Dad going to buy that one for you?
I think so. I got a text from him. He was in Las Vegas for the past week, and I got a text from him saying that he was going to buy it before, as soon as we posted it online. So I think he's got dibs on it. We'll see, though.
All right. It's good stuff for sure, and a good game. A lot of wild lead changes in this, but obviously something to take into the locker room for tomorrow.
Absolutely. You know, I can't be happier with a win. So,
all right.
See you tomorrow, Cass.
All right. Sounds good. Thanks so much.
No
Our
problem.
Steak
Thank
and
you.
Shake player of the game is the captain, Brendan McClue, as he gets his first goal on the power play of the season. And he started out Missouri State with a 1-0 lead. Then Travis Barrett gets his fifth for Missouri State at 18:09 of the first, and for some reason, Missouri State, well, they were feeling very confident. Everything was going good. But things changed after that, because at 19:52, 8.5 seconds left in the period, it was a goal by Nick Krivokucha. As Missouri State gives up the rebound in front, they were trying to clear the puck, actually, and they gave it up in front, and it's a 2-1 game. But the Ice Bears come back. Brennan Anderson, he gets his fourth of the season to make it a 3-1 hockey game. And for Missouri State, things looking a little bit better. They were able to respond. Well, this is one where Anderson picked the upper corner. And Dirks was kind of arguing that maybe there should have been some kind of interference. But as Missouri State takes that 3-1 lead, then it's Dentmeyer to say, not so fast, because St. Louis comes back, his 14th, Dittmar's 14th, the assist to Beschel, and Missouri State finds themselves with a one-goal advantage. Then it is Blake Friend getting his first of the season, this on a second-effort rebound, and Missouri State on the assist by Capron finds it a 3-3 hockey game. Speaking of Capron, Neal gets his sixth of the season. Dettmeyer and Komet And it is now 4-3, and all of a sudden, St. Louis has the advantage. But as quickly as that happens, Anderson comes back on the power play for Missouri State. Anderson with his fifth of the season, Brown and Kovacic to make it a 4-4 hockey game. But just as things go one way, it goes the other way for the other team in St. Louis. Just moments later with Tim Komet getting his second goal of the season. The assist goes to Trigilian and to Detmeyer, and it's a 5-4 game. Then it's a 6-4 game. This one is Isaac Ryder getting a shorthanded goal. Just a clearing pass that goes past the glove of Joey McConnell. The shorthanded goal pulls McConnell, but then Missouri State starts things again as Travis Barrett gets credit for a goal, his 15th, as this one comes up, and it was knocked in by the goaltender Dirks, and Missouri State is trying to claw their way back at 5-6. Then they make it 6-6 on Austin Davis's goal. Davis with his second of the season at 6:48, and Missouri State is making this a hockey game. Then Andrew Kovacic, he gets credit for a goal. We'll slow it down for you as slow as we can. Kovacic gets credit for a goal that I initially thought hit the back of the pad, but right there in slow motion, it actually looks like that it may have hit the post. But either way, it's called a goal. Kovacic's 13th of the season, 7-6. That is the game winner, and Missouri State ends up winning this hockey game. Don't forget, our next broadcast we'll have for you right here on Web Sports Radio and on KBFL will be tomorrow at 7 o'clock. We'll have it for you right here on the Stan Melton Ice Arena as Missouri State will move into another win, and they now have 8 wins on the season. They improved to 8-5-1-1. St. Louis is 8-3 this season. Big win for Missouri State, albeit a very close one, as they win 7-6 here at MediaCom Ice Park. I'm Steve Kasson for Alex Somm. Thanks for tuning in. Till tomorrow, good night, everyone.
You've been listening to Missouri State Ice Bears Hockey with your host, Steve Kasson. Thank you for tuning in to tonight's game. Ice Bears Hockey is a presentation of DS Sports Enterprises and WebSportsRadio.com.